Any mention of the name Neil Diamond brings recollection of his great songs such as I Am, I Said or Crackling Rosie. But the story of Neil's career over the past 25 years covers more than just his hits. Over the next hour, enjoy the music and words that tell the story of Neil Diamond.
The audience gives you the power and the energy. They want what you have to offer, and therefore, your responsibility is to give them everything that you possibly can.
She got the wet movement, Terry.
She got the wet movement,
hey, Terry, baby.
She got the wet movement.
All right.
She got the wet movement.
The extraordinary Neil Diamond. Almost 25 years on from his first hit single, he's still enthralling fans around the world. The moody, self-contained young man who began peddling his songs in the early 60s might have seemed an unlikely superstar. That he had talent was obvious. What was less obvious was his ferocious determination to succeed. Neil Diamond was born in Brooklyn in January 1941. Descended from Russian and Polish immigrants, the young Neil grew up in a warm, music-loving Jewish family.
I was very close to my dad, and he liked music, and he always had the radio on, so I was exposed to music from the time I was a little child. I guess I was about 14 or 15 years old. I got a guitar and the promise of some guitar lessons if I was diligent and serious about it, and the guitar cost $10, and I paid it off at $1 a week, and it turned out to be a very good investment.
It certainly was, in the long run. During his college years, Neil was struggling to break into New York's famous Tin Pan Alley. He was hired as a songwriter by five different music publishers, and subsequently fired by all of them. By 1964, his former schoolmate Neil Sedaka had scored 13 top 10 hits, whilst Neil Diamond was still unknown and unemployed. But by 1966, his dogged persistence finally paid off, when he landed a recording deal with a small label, Bang Records. Neil's first single for Bang built on the image he had already conveyed to those who knew him, that of the brooding, introspective loner.
Belinda was mine till the time that I found her, holding Jim and loving him. When Sue came along, love me strong, that's what I thought. Yeah, me and Sue, that died too. Don't know that I will, but until I can find me a girl to stay in my own legging behind me, I'll be what I am. Time thing, paper ring. I know it's been done, having one girl who loves you, right or wrong, weak or strong.
By this time married with a young daughter, Neil was hardly a truly solitary man, but the image stuck. More importantly, the single was successful enough to convince Bang Records that here was a singer-songwriter with star potential. And of course, they were right. Neil's second single went straight to number 6.
Baby, love me, yes, yes, she does. All the girls out of sight, yeah. Says she loves me, yes, yes, she does. Gonna show me tonight, yeah. Hey, she got the way to move me, cherry.
She got the way to move me. She got the way to move me,
hey, cherry, baby.
She got the way to move me.
All right.
ketchup on a roof. You know, you know what I'm saying. Can't stand still while the music is playing.
For some reason, when I began recording the songs myself, I began to take a much more personalized kind of interest in them, and just everything improved, you know, the performing, the writing. When you're just writing and you can hide behind someone else's performance and someone else's name on the record, you don't really put as much into it. At least I didn't. Cherry Cherry was written for myself. I was recording at that point, and that was a song that I did on the first session of really what I consider to be the beginning of my career. And we recorded Cherry Cherry and Solitary Man and a song called I Got The Feelin. All three of those were very successful, and I was off and running.
Oh, no, 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 baby, something's wrong. No, 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 that old time fire is gone. It's not so much things you say, love, it's what you don't say I'm afraid of. Taste it. But girl, your eyes tell me it's wasted. I got the feeling I'm feeling fine. Don't have to say it's there in your eyes. Oh, oh my.
I think that those were terrific, you know, for the time that I wrote them. They were, I still like them. It's one of the reasons I still do them in concert. Those songs were great. They've held up for a long time, and I still have very good memories of them all.
Kentucky woman, she shine with her own kind of light. She look at you once in a day, if it's all wrong, looks all right. And I love her. God knows I love her. Kentucky woman, she get to know you, she got to own you. Kentucky woman, well, she ain't the kind make heads turn at the drop of her name. Something inside that she's got turned you on just the same. And she loves me. God knows she loves me. Kentucky woman, she gets to know you, she got to own you. Kentucky woman, I don't want much. Good Lord, step beneath my feet. Gentle touch from that one girl and life is. Talking about Kentucky woman.
1967 turned out to be an extraordinary year for Neil Diamond, with four hits of his own, plus two he wrote for the Monkees, I'm a Believer, and A Little Bit Me, A Little Bit You. In commercial terms, he could hardly have been more successful. But along with his drive for stardom, Diamond was determined to achieve artistic credibility. If he wanted to be taken seriously as a songwriter, being dubbed the Fifth Monkey wasn't going to help. A move to Uni Records in early 68 offered him greater artistic freedom, but it also brought the role of Hit Records to a grinding halt. Neil's first three singles for Uni flopped, and by 1969, he was struggling to reinvent himself as a recording artist. He did it by taking his latest song to a Memphis studio known for two things, the rats in the rafters and the sheer magic created by its house musicians. The song itself was dramatic and unusual, and it too came together as if by magic.
The lyric to Brother Love was written while I was on an airplane going down to Memphis, Tennessee for the recording session. It was written on the plane flight, which is very weird, because to write about a revival meeting on a flight drinking champagne is very weird. I was struck by it because I haven't written lyrics that quickly, generally.